Well, hello, my friends, and welcome back to another episode of the Pursuit of Cabin Living series by Four Expedition. I'm Scott Luthold. Well, we're into mid-January, and as you can see around me here, the weather's been quite nice. We have had some significant snowfall, which you'll see here later in this video. The ski resort is open. The entire mountain is offering skiing. But lately, we've had 50-degree weather, so it's been melting off quite nicely, and it's almost been like spring weather out here. We haven't really been doing a whole lot of work on the cabin. We have done some, which you'll see here in this video also. But mostly we've been doing domestic stuff. I've been working on my taxes. I've been preparing sales tax reports for Four Expedition, doing some client work, planning our wedding and things like that. We are getting ready here real soon to hop in Ghost Cat, our Sprinter RV, and take a little trip down to Arizona with our mountain bikes and my KTM motorcycle. We'll probably get out and do some adventures. We'll be doing some filming of all of that. I am also hoping to be able to spend some time with my son, Colin, and go on a couple of overnight adventures in the Four Expedition Subaru Outback that he now owns. And it does have the rooftop tent and all the accessories and everything, so we'll probably go out and do some adventures in that. And I'll probably provide that as an episode of Four Expedition Adventure coming up here, so watch for that. Otherwise, when we get back, we will be getting a lot of work done on this cabin. We do need to spend February and into early March getting the cabin completed because we do have a lot of other projects coming up, one of which is to build a chapel here right behind me in the woods that we're going to get married in June. So we'll be planning to build that and spending a little bit of time building that little place. And it won't be very big. It's probably going to be about a 16 by 12 structure. It's not going to be a large structure by any means, but it'll be big enough to have as a little sanctuary here on our property, which I'm really excited about. So that's a pretty neat project coming up here. I also am starting to work now that it's 2022 on the Eco Adventure Fest that my friend Damon and I are trying to put together here in Angel Fire, New Mexico. And it'll actually be the first outdoor adventure event in the state like this. So we've got the support of the state of New Mexico and a lot of local organizations and so forth. So we're hoping to be able to put that on sometime in late summer or even early fall. I haven't decided that quite yet. Anyway, so there's a lot to do. This week, we're just kind of getting prepared to hit the road for a little while and getting the cabin all ready, having people watch the place while we're gone and all of that. Make sure everything stays functional, whether it gets, you know, below zero or not, nonetheless. Anyway, we're going to run down to Arizona, spend some time seeing some family, and we'll be providing some videos along the way on that as well. I hope you really enjoy this episode, so sit back and enjoy the ride. Thank you.
those pellets over there. Yikes.
We're gonna need pellets.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out, out. I'm going to Jackson. I'm going to mess around. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Brown.
Hey, guess what we're doing?
What are we doing?
Going to look at some wedding venue stuff.
Wedding venues, that's right.
You turn to lose my coat, cause I'm going to Jackson.
So today, we're going to go and take a look at a couple of venues for hosting our wedding reception. Now, we've talked about hosting the wedding right here on Mantle Rock and at our little chapel in the woods called the Chapel of the Divine Mother. But we might set up a tent on our property and host the whole thing right here at Mantle Rock, but there's a possibility we could have bad weather, so we're gonna go look at a couple of different lodges.
And I'll be waiting in Jackson.
Hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. Out, I'm going to Jackson. And that's a fact. Yeah, we've gone to Jackson. Ain't ever coming back.
Right here we are at the first place. This lodge will sleep 47 people. It's got a gourmet kitchen, it's got a game room, it's a really beautiful place, awesome views, and it's somewhere we might consider hosting our wedding reception. Here we are. I want to show you something really cool. Some of you might have seen this before, but so this pro panel roofing is designed so that the snow starts to slide off. And as you can see up at the very top up in there, it's started to slide this way. But what's really interesting is when it holds on, like right here, it curls, does this really cool curling pattern here. And at some point this will drop off, but it just hasn't done it yet.
I'm pretty sure this might not come with the rental of the place, but hey, we can always ask.
Look at these.
Oh yeah, those are so cute. That's what's cool about touring all these places, all these ideas.
Look at over here.
Big and small. Oh my
gosh. Look over here. Benches, places to put your boots.
Cute.
Here we are. This place is really cool. If you look in here, it's a beautiful gourmet kitchen. Just enormous. But what we really love is the view out the side here and this deck, which is really awesome. Definitely big enough to host a big party. And if we had like 100 people here for a reception, they'd be able to sit out here if the weather's nice. Got an incredible view off the balcony here, looking out toward Eagle Nest, which is out over this ridge over here. And that's, I think that's called Forget Me Not Mountain out there. Over here, you can actually see the view of the ski resort over here. It's a beautiful day here in January. Yesterday was in the 50s. Snow is starting to melt off. All right, so let's go in and check out the rest of this place. I think you'll be pretty impressed with it.
Wow.
Yeah, look at that. Plenty of glasses and plates and things like that that we can use.
Look at that. That's the door.
Fantastic. So this place is called Grand Mountain Retreat. And it is a place that you can rent, just like we're considering doing. When you walk down through here, check out these rooms. There are several rooms like this. This place sleeps over 40 people, I think 47. Here's another one of the bunk rooms. I think these rooms are just incredible. Look at these bunks. Now what's really interesting is back here, this is an example of just one of the bathrooms. These bathrooms are just amazing for large groups. As we make our way down the hallway, there's a couple of really nice bedrooms. So this is the main living room area. It's enormous. Definitely a lodge size room. And this will be a great place for people to hang out as well during the wedding. It's got a nice big fireplace. Plenty of seating. This is gonna be a great place for a venue. All right, so just for fun, we're gonna go down to the basement and show you what's down here. The popcorn machine here, got a pool table, got a shuffleboard, and then back in here, there's another amazing bunk room. I mean, look at this. You can sleep tons of people in here. And there's also, I think behind that door over there, there's ping pong table. Just a really great space to have a party. Anyway, so that's our goal. Our goal is to consider having a reception weekend here. It should be a lot of fun. Great place for people to hang out and have a good time. So there you have it. This is just one of the two places that we're considering. And this one here is halfway between Angel Fire and Eagle Nest. The other facility is right in Angel Fire. We're looking at both properties. Both of them are complete lodges that have sleeping for up to 40 some people. Both have incredible views and just a wonderful experience for what it's like to spend time in a place like this in Angel Fire, New Mexico. Well, so yesterday we went down to Albuquerque. We had a big order of furniture that we had on order, and it finally came in. So we went down there and picked it all up with the trailer. We got a whole new bedroom set, which is a headboard, footboard, drawers underneath the bed, which is something we desperately need. There's two nightstands, a dresser, which we desperately need. And then we got this awesome two-person, it's called a Durango couch. It's leather, two-person couch to go in the corner in the bedroom with an ottoman so we can sit on some furniture to watch movies and things like that. So, and then, whoa, and they also got this beautiful rug to go in the bedroom. We're not gonna be able to put all that. We're gonna put it down temporarily, and then we'll, of course, have to take it all back up in order to be able to put the flooring down when we have time to get that done. But for now, we'll have a whole new bedroom set. Well, call us crazy, but we haven't gotten our floors done yet. And if we're gonna put in this new furniture, we decided we're gonna paint the perimeter around the room because we've got a big rug. We don't want that rug to get all dirty. We're not gonna do the wood flooring until after the walls and ceiling are done because, well, we don't wanna drop things on the nice wood floor. And that's generally how you do it. You do the floors last. So Heather's gonna roll out the floors here. And then we ended up getting rid of the big, beautiful headboard that I made. We're gonna put that back in storage because we got a really nice bedroom set that we'll show you here in a little bit. But once we get this done, then, you know, now we're kind of into 2022. We're going to start working on getting the bathroom finished and everything else as well. But we got to get this furniture in the house. And of course, this is only a 640 square foot cabin. And we've got a huge pile of boxes out here with furniture that we've got to get in and out of the elements. So we're going to get this done and get this new bed in and get the floors rolled and then move on to other things. I think we might want to do the whole hallway.
Yeah.
I mean, look how beautiful.
You should just do the whole floor. Look at that fun texture.
That looks great. Yeah, let's just paint the insulation and we're done. And the ceiling. We just paint the walls and ceiling.
Clouds up there. It's like blue sky and clouds.
I think Heather's a little tired of living like this.
High on fumes. And a little bit tired of the construction chaos.
Yeah. But what's really cool about living like this...
It's okay for me. It's ours.
It's ours. But what's really cool about living like this is you just put nails anywhere you want. All right. Well, Heather's inside painting the floors. I'm out here unwrapping all of this furniture. And this furniture we got down in Albuquerque at a place called Furniture Row. I have to say, I'm pretty impressed with that place. The sales was amazing. The product, the way this product is packaged is really, really well packaged. And all this stuff was made in Indonesia and shipped here. So the quality of the furniture that they carry at that place is really, really nice. And I am just incredibly impressed with how they've wrapped this stuff.
New bedroom set. Yay! So much junk like here. We told you last time on the video that no one sees what's behind that wall over there and all the chaos, but actually right now this is our chaos. New furniture. It's chaos in here. He's out there right now unwrapping all the rest because what we did, flooring isn't going to be done yet, so what we decided to do was paint the perimeter, put in the new bedroom set. We have a huge rug going right here, like 10 by 7 or 10 by 8, and then our fun new chair over there.
So as you can see, I do things pretty systematically. We have to cut this all up and put it in a recycle bin, and you have to fold it all up and cut it all up in order to put it in the bin. So rather than trying to take it all out of the box and then cutting it up later, I'm just cutting all the box parts off as I go.
Don't break your ankle. Mm-hmm. Our new nightstands and the dresser drawers that go under the bed. These are made in Indonesia. Look at how beautiful the wood is. So excited for this. Having a place to put things will be amazing, especially in this little 650 square foot cabin. It's not there yet. Already. See if it opens. How far? Well, probably not that far to the wall.
No, I think we can come my way.
Okay.
Okay, keep going up.
You filmed that, right?
Yeah.
Now you can push it that way.
Now it can move.
There we go.
I mean, I think it still looks awesome. Together?
Together.
Look, we could even fit a little dog.
This is nice.
That was a lot. A lot.
It was a lot.
Oh my gosh.
I love it though. What do you think?
Yeah, we tilt that out. It's pretty.
Honey, our bedroom. How many people do you want to be able to see plus have an island though?
Well, I guess if it's you and me, if there's two of us right here, and then say we have another person, they're right there.
Mm-hmm.
We at least want to have like two more feet at least on each side or something. So that way we have like the space for the aisle.
So pews, how many pews? Two?
Yeah, something like that.
So four pews, two seats, so eight people can see inside. We agree on 16 feet long by 12 wide for the main space, right?
Yes.
And the reason we're going to do that is why?
Easy measurements for construction, building,
materials.
Materials,
yeah.
Yes.
That's right, because OSB boards, for instance, are
4x8,
and then we do 16 on center,
yeah,
and all that. All right, so then imagine, so if this is the door, then we're going to have a pop-out that'll be sort of like a mudroom entrance. And that'll be, what, maybe 3 feet deep?
Yeah.
By about, what do we say, wide?
Six.
I think 6 feet wide. And that'll pop out on the front. And then up on the altar, we talked about doing like a little angled thing with maybe an angled roof coming down.
Right.
Okay.
Because if we have... we're going to have that bump out, like that 6 foot with the door.
Yeah.
That way it's like a little grand entrance. Like for us, we're going to get married probably out on the stoop, right?
Yeah, we'll get married outside.
With everybody.
If we have a big wedding.
With everybody.
Yeah. If we have a big wedding, anybody wants to have a big wedding here can stand outside on the front step in front of the chapel. And if you're having a small wedding, I think we could probably fit, let's see, if we say two pews or two pews, so that's 2, 4, 6, 8. And then in the back, there's still enough room to probably put another four chairs. So we could probably get 12 people inside the chapel for anybody that wants to have a small wedding, but big weddings would be outside.
And some things will happen in winter. Like we might have like some really cool little Christmas gatherings, our own little services, and our Sunday church.
Yeah, our Sunday church, Christmas Eve services
will
just be inside our own chapel, our own little sanctuary. All right, cool. So should we draw it out?
Yes.
All right, cool. Let's draw this out.
See, your art skills are like coming in now and good handiness.
That's right.
Notice how I asked you to draw this out, not me.
We have a contest later. I'll draw it and we'll see what the audience thinks. Whose is better?
Yeah, that's right.
Beautiful, honey. Good job.
So this would be the front door. And then you'd want it to be big enough to where somebody could, you know, a minister could stand here and two, you know, bride and groom.
Right.
And then still have a place where maybe down on the next step you have, you know, maid of honor and best man. But then inside you got kind of your central aisle, right?
Right.
And then you got your altar here with a step. And then you maybe got a, you know, foot room, pew, although you think maybe the pew should be on an angle.
I do, yeah.
So kind of like,
right,
like that. And then another pew.
Yeah.
Like so.
And they can be like very skinny pews, not the modern, like something old.
Right, from basically here to here, we said that was 16 feet.
Yeah.
And then from here to here, we said was 12 feet.
Mm-hmm.
12 feet. And then we said this aisle was going to be 4 feet, right?
Well, we
Yes, but when we measured it out, it only came to 3.
8 feet.
So if we have, we just have to make our pews a little.
Yeah, like the pews.
Pews that are small enough.
Yeah, or make have them made right. Or something like that. So we have a 4-foot aisle, and then we said how big was from here to here? We said it was 5 feet.
Yeah, about 5.
5 feet, and then we said this pop out from here to here was 3 feet, I think. The interior,
yeah.
3 feet, and how wide did we say this? 6 feet, right?
Six.
This was 6 feet across. I don't know. What do you think? You think that's sufficient?
Yeah, I like it.
So this is our chapel.
It's nice because having it drawn out is things that we can go out and like treasure hunt for. Like we know we need a really ornate, fun door
yeah.
for the front.
Yeah.
Some old stained glass windows.
Kind of like
yeah.
Kind of like that, right?
Right. If only the build was as easy as you made it look right there.
And then up here, we talked about building like a
steeple.
Yeah, or like a bell tower or something like that. Have that pop out. This is open. Right, and then maybe like a. Cross up there or something.
Yeah.
Double windows.
So in search of old rustic windows.
Yep.
We would love to have stained glass. So if anybody knows anybody that has some stained glass that.
Oh yeah, if we could find some cool old stained glass.
Yep.
So then this would kind of pop out. Angle. And then I want this to be kind of a tall foundation.
Right. Then we're going
to
put what? Old stone on the side?
Yeah, we'll stone it. Exactly.
What type of roof are we thinking?
I was thinking maybe corrugated or maybe a rusted or like a patinaed copper.
Copper?
Like who wouldn't want to get married in that?
I do. How about tomorrow?
Let's do it tomorrow. And then up here, maybe kind of a cool stained glass. Got your door. Some cool old door. There you go.
This looks like the Little House on the Prairie Chapel Church.
Exactly.
Perfect.
There's our church, our chapel.
What's it called?
Chapel of the Divine Mother.
Beautiful, honey.
Let's do it. Let's build it.
Let's do it.
If you build it, they will come.
Yes. We need to build it so we can get married.
That's right. All right.
I love it.
We're sneaking up on a porcupine. There's a porcupine that was just walking across the back of our property. I'm trying to be really quiet to get over there and see him. There he is. There he is. Just learned by watching a show on Netflix called Alone that porcupines have a lot of fat on them. So they're good eating when you're trying to survive. But you have to be really careful of those quills. He's looking right at you.
He blends into the dead grass and the wood. That's awesome. Oh my gosh. Maybe he'd go up the tree. Alright, so this afternoon, we're gonna go for a little mountain bike ride. It's actually pretty warm out. I shouldn't say that, it's pretty cold out, but it's warmer than cold out. And we miss being on our bikes, so. You ready to go, Miss Heather?
Yeah.
Alright,
Heather's got this awesome Pivot. Some of you have seen this before. Full suspension mountain bike. And then over here, as many of you have seen before, I got my Trek 1120. Excited to get on this bike. Let's do it.
Well, hey, gotta show everybody. We didn't do this on purpose.
Yeah, there you go.
I like our gear.
We didn't do this on purpose. But we're now,
because
we're living because we're living together in a 640 square foot cabin in the woods, we become the Bopsy twins. Go toward the sun.
Yeah.
Let's go toward the sun.
I'm not laughing at you, honey.
I think the seat went up my butt.
Hey, at least we're not clipped in here.
My butt. Ice and hard snow drifts. One-handed biking with a camera. Dang.
See this? See this?
Oh.
Mud.
My sphincter hurts.
I got these tires.
And these boots. Holy crap.
Come on, Pokey.
I can't shift with holding on to this. My shifter's on the other side.
Ah. What's that? Ooh, we got ice. butt mud. This is what happens when you live in a cabin in the woods eating pizza and eating pizza and banana bread all day. We haven't been working very hard lately. We took about a month off. And I tell you, we're out of shape. We're gonna be heading down to Arizona here pretty quick. Spend a little bit of time down there. We're gonna take our mountain bikes with us.
Heck, we might even take the motorcycle. So we're up for a ride pretty soon. Get back in good shape. You go, girl. On my shoulders makes me happy.
Yeah, you know, I think the other roads are going to be icy because they don't get as much sun. So, beautiful place we live. Look, people, there's stuff for sale everywhere. So if you want to live somewhere beautiful, New Mexico it is. Out of shape. I don't think I should either, but.
All uphill coming now. All icy, snowy uphill. Oh. Kind of a scary proposition. Riding on ice, one-handed. Show you how easy I can pedal past Heather. Holding a camera, pedaling one-handed.
I'm waiting for you.
Come on, lady. Oh. We're spinning out on the ice. We better get home and eat some pizza.
All right.
I don't need studs in my tires either.
You are a stud. Ooh.
My nose is dripping and my toes are nipping.
I think I have fingers in there somewhere. Okay.
All right.
Put the camera on.
All right, we're heading down this way. Our road's looking pretty good. Sun hits this one a lot more, so it melts off. We're on the back side behind our property. We'll be coming around again to the left to the front side. Glad I'm in such good shape.
I was thinking that. You're in fantastic shape. You can't tell all these layers. But.
You know, I think that that porcupine, which by the way, we've named Porky, is in way better shape than we are. After we scared him up, he climbed up that tree like nothing.
Look, we went 2.55 miles.
What?
And our elevation is 8,700.
80. 70. Okay, you know.
8,770.
All right, I guess we're not wimps.
That's pretty good.
8,700 feet, and it's probably, what, 20 degrees out? My lift. I'm trying to talk, but my lifts are kind of numb, and I can't really talk that well. Anyway.
It's fun.
It's fun. I'm glad we went out and did this. What have you been doing? I know some of my friends out there live in other countries in the Southern Hemisphere, enjoying summertime right now. But if you're like us, you're up here in the winter. Of course, we also have a lot of friends in Arizona, mm-hmm. in southerner, well, it's only about, I'd say it's only straight south from here would only be about 5 hours, but it's about 9.5, 10 hours drive from here as the crow flies going southwest. But a lot of those people are down there probably mountain biking on the trails and shorts.
Yeah.
And I don't like to talk about that too much because Heather starts to get a straight face like that. But, yeah, it's nice to get out and enjoy the winter. We don't have cross-country skis. We did get a set of snowshoes recently, both of us. But we haven't really got enough snow right now to snowshoe, so we're looking forward to getting another big snowfall. So hopefully that'll come in the next couple, yeah.
Month?
Maybe in the next month, yeah.
Yeah.
Anyhow.
Now it's time for dinner.
Yeah, pizza with a dessert of banana bread.
Banana bread, some... ice
or maybe
cream,
some rhubarb pie sauce. And ice cream, caramel sauce.
We did get cookies.
Oh, we have homemade cookies we can make. We've earned it. Wouldn't you say we've earned it?
Yeah, we burned like 190 calories.
Oh my God, yeah.
We got this.
We got this.
All right, my friends, I think that's it for this episode of the Pursuit of Cabin Living series by Four Expedition. I really hope you enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed creating it. If you haven't become a subscriber of mine, I encourage you to hit that subscribe button. Of course, be sure to hit that notification bell to be notified when videos go live. And if you consider yourself to be an adventurer and you're looking for an adventure community, consider joining Team 4X by going to 4expedition.com/join to learn more. Until the next time, take care.